Data, look at this.
Data.
What?
My name. It is pronounced Data.
Oh?
You called me Data.
What's the difference?
One is my name. The other is not.
Oh, you did know he's attracted to me, didn't you?
Untrue, I don't...
Stop this petty bickering, all of you! Especially you, mother!
Could you please continue the petty bickering? I find it most intriguing. I will make another attempt. Baby needs a new pair of shoes. Goodbye, Jordy. I shall miss you at weapons systems analysis.
Uh-huh. And I guess you'll just have to arm your photon torpedoes without me.
As well as our hydrogen collectors. Fond farewell.
Because of Data's wonderful after-dinner conversation, his anecdotes are the stuff of legends aboard this ship.
So, by using the square root of pi and multiplying it by 9 to the third power, I was able to accurately calculate the distance between the Omicron system and the Crab Nebula.
Oh. Fascinating, Data. Absolutely fascinating. I'm sure Mrs. Troy would love to hear the one about the anomalous chemical composition of brown dwarf stars.
Not really.
Yes, Captain. That is a particularly spellbinding subject. In most stars, the rare earth element europium is enriched relative to samarium and gadolinium.
That's so.
It is, however.
I don't know, Data. He looked perfectly normal to me.
In solitude. There is nothing to trigger unusual behavior.
Good point. Let's not tamper with the status quo.
But that would defeat the opportunity for our behavioral research. In all probability, he is simply lonely. We can relieve his anxiety through socialization.
Be my guest.
Excuse me, Lieutenant. You seem to have lost the will to communicate with others. You have friends here. We care about you. Why, just recently, Jordy Wesley and I were saying...
With all due respect, be gone! Sir.
He seems quite sincere in his desire for solitude.
Seeing is believing, huh?
Then you have beaten him.
It is a matter of perspective, Doctor. In the strictest sense, I did not win.
Data.
I busted him up.
Yes!
Your leeway has run out, Captain.
Wesley, was our attempt to make you uncomfortable effective?
You bet it was. For a second there, I thought I was on the wrong ship.
Did you find our deception pleasing?
Yeah.
What are you looking at?
I'm not looking at anything, sir. I'm continuing to organize my files.
But you were looking at me.
I am sorry if I was disturbing you, sir. I will not look in your direction.
I'm afraid we cannot allow you to warn your guards.
Not bad.
We have to realign the entire power grid. We'll all be burning the midnight oil in this one.
That would be inadvisable.
Excuse me?
But I'm absolutely certain that we met once at Pelora's Colony.
I've never been to Pelora's Colony.
Neither have I. Why don't we find out what else we have in common?
Extremely rude behavior.
Calvin Hutchinson. Call me Hutch. Calvin, awful name. I've never forgiven my parents. Soon as I saw you, I knew you had to be the Enterprise's first officer.
Oh,
of course. Your reputation precedes you. Flashing blue eyes, square jaw, quite the ladies' man, I hear. Now, don't be modest, Will. Oh, may I call you Will?
Sure.
I also hear that you're a musician. I certainly hope you'll play something for us. It's not often we get to entertain the command crew of the flagship. Oh, and speaking of command.
Thanks, Data.
Excuse me, I'm just finishing up a speech for you, Mr. Spock. I rather enjoy writing. I don't get to do it very often in this job.
Perhaps you would be happier in another job. Timothy, your head movements are counterproductive. Can you be still?
How do you do it?
The servo mechanisms in my neck are designed to approximate human movements. I did not realize the effect was so distracting.
I like it.
How is your diplomatic assignment progressing?
Fine.
I have heard that in moments of diplomatic tension, it is often helpful to find elements of commonality.
Master Byleth is demanding, temperamental, and rude.
You share all of those qualities in abundance. Perhaps you should try to build on your similarities. I reckon the process should take less than 2 hours.
What did you say?
I said the process should take less than 2 hours.
No, you said, I reckon.
According to my memory logs, I did not use those words.
Y'all must be mistaken.
There, Data, you did it again.
Did what?
Spot, you are disrupting my ability to work.
Vamoose, you little varmint.
Enter.
Hello, Data.
Counselor?
What are you doing?
I've been watching Spot sleep. In the past 15 minutes, he has had 12 muscle spasms, which indicates he was dreaming. I have often wondered what Spot dreams about. His twitching and rapid breathing would seem to suggest anxiety. But Spot has never seen a mouse, or any other form of rodentia. Goodbye, Spot. He will need to be fed once a day. He prefers feline supplement number 25.
I understand.
And he will require water. And you must provide him with a sandbox. And you must talk to him. Tell him he is a pretty cat. And a good cat.
I will feed him.
Perhaps that will be enough. Spot. Spot. Down. Spot. Down. Down. Spot.
Down. This is down. Down is good.
This is up. Up is no. One moment.
Come in.
Data, I had another idea that might help boost the power conversion levels. Can you give me a hand?
I would be happy to.
Don't tell me you're trying to teach the cat to use the console.
It is part of her training program. I am teaching Spot to jump down from the desk on my command.
How's it going?
I have not been entirely successful. Feline supplement number 221.
Data, that cat definitely has a mind of her own. Maybe she's just not trainable.
I suppose I must accept that possibility. It may be that Spot lacks the intelligence necessary to learn the appropriate responses to my commands.
I don't know about Spot, but it seems to me your training is coming along just fine. Come on, let's go.
In order to experience the surprise during birth, I believe I will preserve the mystery until then.
I know what you mean. I don't want to know either.
Lissa?
Spot's not the only one who's going to be a mother.
Oh, Lissa, that's wonderful!
How did Andrew take the news?
He was a little shocked, but he's getting over it.
Oh. I've spent the past 9 weeks as an expectant parent. I would be happy to share my insights with your husband. If my experience is any indication, he will need all the help he can get.
Me?
It is possible that it will take several days for Captain Picard and me to complete our mission. I would prefer to have a human present to supervise the birthing process.
Well, I'd be honored. Yes. Ooh.
I have noticed that you are the only other member of the crew whom Spot seems to like.
Really? That's hard to believe.
You're such a sweet little kitty.
She is to you. However, there have been several injuries to other members of the crew who have attempted to care for Spot.
So, has she, picked a place?
A place?
Cats usually like to pick a specific location to give birth, and it's usually dark and secluded, and I believe this is it. I'm curious, sir. Who's the father?
I am not certain. Spot has escaped from my quarters on several occasions, and there are 12 male felines on board. I intend to run a full DNA analysis on the kittens once they...
Picard to Data. Report to Shuttle Bay 2.
On my way, sir. Goodbye, Spot. I believe you are in good hands.
You have nothing to worry about, sir.
It would appear that Spot has had her kittens.
They sound hungry.
Yes. I am curious as to why Spot is not caring for them.
Music?
Yes, sir. Mozart's Jupiter Symphony in C major, Bach's Brandenburg Concerto No. 3, Beethoven's Ninth Symphony Second Movement, Molto Vivace, and La Donna e Mobile from Verdi's Rigoletto.
You think you could thin it out a bit?
Computer, eliminate program 1. Computer, eliminate program 2. Computer, eliminate program 3. Computer, half volume.
How the hell can you listen to 4 pieces of music at the same time?
Actually, I'm capable of distinguishing over 150 simultaneous compositions. But in order to analyze the aesthetics, I try to keep it to 10 or less.
Only 4 today?
I am assisting Commander LaForge with a very complex calculation.
deeper than did ever plummet sound. Captain? Sir, your attention is wandering.
Data, I can barely see you.
But, sir, I'm supposed to be attempting a Neoplatonic magical rite. The darkness is appropriate for such a ritual. Throughout the ages, from Keats to Giacomo, poets have composed odes to individuals who have had a profound effect upon their lives. In keeping with that tradition, I have written my next poem in honor of my cat. I call it Ode to Spot. Felis catus, is your taxonomic nomenclature an endothermic quadruped, carnivorous by nature? Your visual, olfactory, and auditory senses contribute to your hunting skills and natural defenses. I find myself intrigued by your subvocal oscillations, a singular development of cat communications that obviates your basic hedonistic predilection for a rhythmic stroking of your fur to demonstrate affection. A tail is quite essential for your acrobatic talents. You would not be so agile if you lacked its counterbalance. And when not being utilized to aid in locomotion, it often serves to illustrate the state of your emotion. Commander, you have anticipated my denouement. However, the sentiment is appreciated. I will continue. Oh, Spot, the complex levels of behavior you display connote a fairly well-developed cognitive array. And though you are not sentient, Spot, and do not comprehend, I nonetheless consider you a true and valued friend.
Troy to Data.
Data here.
How are you doing?
I encountered a minor difficulty, Counselor, but it has been dealt with. I am ready to depolarize the power grid.
What are you doing?
In disrupting the detection net, the Romulans may have caused a residual tachyon signature to form around their own ships.
But we have no way of detecting it.
All stop.
Aye, sir. All stop.
Sir, the fleet's been ordered to Gamma Eridon.
Tachyon signatures will not last long. By the time the fleet is deployed, it will be too late. Begin to reconfigure the sensors to detect ionized particle traces.
The entire area has been flooded with tachyon particles. We'll never be able to find what we're looking for.
I am aware of the difficulties. Please bring the phasers back online.
That will flood three decks with radiation.
We will initiate radiation protocol when necessary.
You don't give a damn about the people whose lives you're throwing away. We're not just machines.
Mr. Hobson, you will carry out my orders or I will relieve you of duty.
Yes, sir.
The Enterprise wants to know the reason we've stopped.
Display sensor schematic. Display sensor sweep maximum range.
Are you going to answer the Enterprise?
Overlay display with tachyon emissions. Highlight any tachyon signatures which show subspace inertial displacement. Concentrate a sensor sweep in that area.
Sir, this is pointless. Those readings could be anything. There's no way for us to be sure the Romulans are out there.
Reconfigure photon torpedo warhead yields. Set for high energy burst level 6.
Level 6? But that won't even...
Do it!
Torpedo's ready. Another message coming in. It's Captain Picard.
Mr. Data, you were ordered to rendezvous with the fleet at Gamma Eridon. Acknowledge.
Stand by, Captain. Mr. Hobson, prepare to fire.
Didn't you hear? Captain Picard wants us...
Fire.
Fire!
Disrupting the detection net, the Romulans may have caused a residual tachyon signature to form around their own ships.
But we have no way of detecting it.
All stop.
Thanks, sir. All stop.
Sir, the fleet's been ordered to Gamma Eridon. Tachyon signatures will not last long. By the time the fleet is deployed, it will be too late. Begin to reconfigure the sensors to detect ionized particle traces.
The entire area's been flooded with tachyon particles. We'll never be able to find what we're looking for.
I am aware of the difficulties. Please bring the phasers back online.
That will flood three decks with radiation.
We will initiate radiation protocol when necessary.
You don't give a damn about the people whose lives you're throwing away. We're not just machines.
Mr. Hobson, you will carry out my orders or I will relieve you of duty.
Yes, sir.
They're changing course, heading back to Romulan space.
Make a full report to the flagship. Take the main phasers offline and begin radiation cleanup of the affected decks.
Yes, sir.
Captain.
Captain, I wish to submit myself for disciplinary action. I have disobeyed a direct order from a superior officer. Although the result of my actions proved positive, the ends cannot justify the means.
No, they can't. However, the claim I was only following orders has been used to justify too many tragedies in our history. Starfleet doesn't want officers who will blindly follow orders without analyzing the situation. Your actions were appropriate for the circumstances. And I have noted that in your record. Mr. Data. Nicely done.
Sir. Dismissed. It may be possible, sir, but it would not be advisable.
I'll take that as a yes. You're with me.
Commander Data, welcome on board. It's so very good to see you.
It is good to see you too, sir.
I could use your help with the infuser array.
Certainly.
As you can see, we're having problems with the plasma conduits.
This will need a completely new field induction subprocessor. It appears we will be required to ignite the Midnight Petroleum, sir.
Admiration for Dr. Soong's accomplishment. But his intention was to create an artificial life form. I created the exocomps to be tools. And there is a big difference between Data and a tool.
Doctor, there is a big difference between you and a virus. But both are alive.
The transporter system just went dead. There's some kind of malfunction.
Run a diagnostic immediately. Try bypassing...
Commander, that will not be necessary. The transporter is not malfunctioning. I have locked out the controls.
Everything started, Will. We set everything in motion. It's like the chicken and the egg. Will, the chicken and the egg. We think it started in the past, but it didn't. It started right here, in the future. That's why it's getting larger in the past.
I think I know what the captain is talking about. If I'm not mistaken, he's describing a paradox.
Yes, right, that's it.
Intriguing. It is possible. We could have caused the very anomaly we've been looking for. Let us assume for a moment that the captain has been traveling through time. Let us also assume he has initiated a tachyon pulse at the same coordinates in all three time periods. In that case, it is possible that the convergence of three tachyon pulses could have ruptured the subspace barrier and created an anti-time reaction.
I see where you're going, Data. And because anti-time operates opposite the way normal time does, the effects would travel backwards through the space-time continuum.
Yes, that's why it gets larger in the past. It grows as it travels backwards in time.
All right. Just for the moment, let's say that you're right. What do we do?
Back, Will. We go back to the Devron system.
He may be right.
If we go back to the Devron system now, we might be able to see the initial formation of the anomaly.
Riker to bridge, set a course for the dev run system maximum warp.
Aye, sir.
I have an idea. If we take the ship to the center of the anomaly and create
a static warp shell,
it could repair the barrier and collapse the anomaly. Yes, sir.
Mr. Data, you are a clever man in any time period.
If only you could feel rage over Varia's death. If only you could feel a need for revenge, then maybe you could fire.
But you're just an android. You can't feel anything, can you? It's just another interesting intellectual puzzle for you. Another of life's curiosities.
I cannot permit this to continue.
Wait, your program won't allow you to fire. You can't fire me.
No.
I'm reading a weapon in transit with Commander Data. It seems to have discharged, sir.
Discharged?
I'm deactivating it.
Welcome back, Mr. Data. You all right?
Yes, Commander. Please arrange to have Kivas Fajo taken into custody. On charges of murder, kidnapping, theft.
The arrangements have already been made.
A Veron T disruptor. It belongs to Fajo.
Mr. O'Brien says the weapon was in a state of discharge.
Perhaps something occurred during transport, Commander. I'm proud of you, son. I wasn't sure you'd ever develop the cognitive abilities to make it this far. But if you're here, if you can see me, you've crossed over the threshold from being a collection of circuits and subprocessors and have started a wonderful journey. Do you believe that we are in some way alike, sir?
In many ways, I'd like to believe.
Then it is all right for you to die, because I will remain alive. You know that I cannot grieve for you, sir.
You will. In your own way.
How sad, dear brother. You make me wish I were an only child.
Data.
To prepare, I have scanned all available literature on parenting. There seems to be much confusion on this issue. One traditional doctrine insists spare the rod and spoil the child, suggesting a punitive approach, while another more liberal attitude would allow the child enormous freedom.
Data.
And what Klingons do to their children.
Data, I am not talking about parenting. I am talking about the extraordinary consequences of creating a new life.
Does that not describe becoming a parent, sir?
This was really important to you, wasn't it?
You said earlier that I am unique. If so, then I am alone in the universe. When I began investigating the exocomps, I realized I might be encountering a progenitor of myself. Suddenly, the possibility exists that I am no longer alone. At times, I too find it difficult to share my thoughts with others. I am not always confident that I am expressing myself in a manner which humans can comprehend. But I do know that...
sound like you don't want to be an android.
I am an android. That will never change.
But if you could change, would you?
I have often wished to be human. I study people carefully in order to more closely approximate human behavior.
Why? We're stronger and smarter than humans. We can do more than they can.
But I cannot take pride in my abilities. I cannot take pleasure in my accomplishments.
But we never have to feel bad either.
I would gladly risk feeling bad at times, if it also meant that I could taste my dessert. I understand your dilemma. I once had what could be considered a crisis of the spirit.
You?
Yes. The Starfleet officers who first activated me on Omicron Theta told me I was an android. Nothing more than a sophisticated machine with human form. However, I realized that if I were simply a machine, I could never be anything else. I could never grow beyond my programming. I found that difficult to accept. So I chose to believe that I was a person, that I had the potential to be more than a collection of circuits and subprocessors. It is a belief which I still hold.
How did you come to your decision?
I made a leap of faith.